Alright. Well, here it is. I took mine. It put it all out here. Simplified it a little bit, because mine, I tried compacting it and hiding it and everything, and it took quite a while. I'll show you all how that one works. This one is quite simple. I even put the whole thing around the door. You can add more of these. More you, just keep going. Knock yourselves out. Well, you do add more, though. I'll just do that really quick. Show you. So you wanted three more switches. Let's say I'm not actually going to put it all on there. I'm not going to deal with all that right now. Oops. Go the same thing. Another block here with the switch here. Link. I refer to MineWiki a lot for all this stuff. In case you guys didn't know that existed. Yeah, Minecraft Wiki. It's definitely the coolest thing. And then you'd link that up to this, and then that all the way over to that. Same thing, just more switches, levers. So what you're gonna wanna do for a tutorial, I guess, is first set up your three switches. Generally, they'll start off all down to power. Down to send power. To set it, that's where you set up your combination. Right at the beginning, decide which ones you would like to go up to power. So you put two torches, you put a torch behind each one. You want to be different than the one. So that when these two are down, this one's up, sends power, it's off to the AND gate. Alright, so you put that, you link those all up, do one inverter, torch, block. Simple. Take some redstone. You know, this all can be compacted, and I like to space it out a little bit because redstone is, look at that, it messes everything up. So there's that. This is your AND gate. It's two redstone torches, one redstone wire in between, and a torch in the front. Link your first gates here to this one here. And you're gonna want to set up your button. Now, there is a different way of doing this than just putting the redstone on top here. So you don't have to, because you can't build on top of redstone. I'm not gonna show you that right now, because when I do that, I tend to have a lot of problems and it takes a lot of problem solving. If you want me to show you that, I can. That's how mine's running. I'll show you that after this. So what you're gonna do is set up your switch here, your button, and then just run it along into your AND gate to this side. Now, an AND gate means when one side's giving power, so that we have the right combination right now, so it sends out power. And then when the other side sends out power, it lets this one turn on and sends out more power, only if both are going. Say we do that, click that guy off, so there's no power. This guy, he sends power, but nothing happens. Yeah, amazing. Alright, from that, you're going to link it up to this. I actually have no idea what the name for it is. Something where it keeps it so when I switch it, it just switches states. So it keeps, because regularly, if you push a button up to a door, you press the button, it's only open for two or three seconds. This way it makes it so you can put your button far away, and it'll stay open until you're inside, and you press reset button. So all you need is a 3x3 space. You put one block in either corner, just like this. Torch, two pieces of redstone. There you go. And then set up your button, come out the back of one of this one. Over, and then your button. You're going to want to put that in your base, because that's what's going to close the door. And then link it up. I like to dig it underneath, and then just hold on. And just link it up to the door, the block underneath the door. Make sure it's actually pointing into it, or else it won't work. And then this pad right here, make sure the redstone wire does not touch the block underneath the pad or around the pad, or else it'll just mess up your whole circuit. Okay, well, so we got our right combination in. Mine is down, down, up, or up, up, or up, down, down, whatever. Press the button. Door opens. Walk on casually over to our door, walk over all this, and close. Look at that. Now we want to leave, because that button will not open the door. Look at that. Can't open the door with anything out of the way. Pretty nifty, I thought. I thought when I first saw this and read about it and all that, I thought it was just the coolest thing. And then there's adding machines, of course, but let's not get into that. I'm going to try adding two more. I add some more here so it can be all cool. Okay. So yeah, I did. Now it's up, down, 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 up. Transmit power to this block. Now I hope that's. Remember, the block only travels, or the power only travels 15 blocks, so. Actually, that'd be an inverter, so that's gonna make it an opposite. Sorry, I completely forgot about that. Look at that, we're setting up power now. So now, what we just did, add a simple, made a six. Six switch combination lock. I hope this improves the security at your house, keeps the creepers out, and the diamonds in. I'll start the train track tutorial soon. This is my castle, by the way. I don't know if I've actually showed any of you that. But this is actually running completely off Bob's tutorial. So that's where I learned it. That's where I tried it. I'll show you the wiring. I'll break it all down to the very last little, just to set it up just like this. So you can just go in, sit in this, watch the cart come around. Shoot me around, back up. This isn't actually going anywhere. This was my original testing. I built this while watching his video. It's not going to go through. I hope you like my texture pack. I hope I didn't make things too difficult or anything. So I thought it's fun. I think it's funny, personally. Yeah. So this is my lock combination lock tutorial. I hope it was helpful. If not, comment. If it was, comment. I like to hear from you guys. I like the 5 subscribers I have. Thank you. Alright. Well, thanks.